I mean, how did it come about? I came up with an idea, but why I came up with that idea, I honestly don't know. I was on a flight on the way back from the UK. I had a lot of time on my hands, and something popped into my brain that I think had been seated there for 20 years, and I thought, you know what, it's time we did this.
Cameron, one of our founding member, he gave me a call and says, hey Anthony, do you want to build a solar car? So I said, what do we know about solar cars, Cameron?
Australia's got a lot of space. It's just open, empty space that gets an enormous amount of sun. And to me, it seemed completely illogical that we weren't taking advantage of this. And one of the reasons I think we weren't is we need to have the local skills and talent to understand that that is a real potential and that we can do that. My day job is running an IT company, and I see so many young professionals with incredible talent going overseas post-graduation because they say that's where the opportunities are. And I think we need to change that mindset. We need to be able to show people, no, the opportunities are here because the talent's here.
I developed a tablet which just shows the speed, shows the battery power, shows the battery percentage, all sorts of temperatures, and that can be used in all of the cars, the lead vehicle, the chase vehicle, and as well as the solar car. In any racing, IT is extremely important, but solar racing, without it, there would be no car. There would be no racing. It's the brains behind everything we do.
This competition has been running for over 20 years now, and we're seeing the technology from this competition is starting to move its way into mainstream cars now. So it really does push the cutting edge of electric cars and solar power and clean energy in the modern world. We can run this car for free across the continent at 85k an hour using the power of the sun, and I think that's just astonishing.
Goal number one is to finish. It's an incredibly arduous race. Last race, less than half the teams made it across the finish line.
We're a green team, we made a lot of bookie mistakes, so I think over the last 2 years we've been practicing a lot and drilling and learning more about the car and really getting ourselves together as a team, so we're a much better team now than we were before.
Goal number two, we'd like to pick up probably about 3 spots from where we were last time. So we finished 7th in the last race. The reality is most of this boils down to the quality of the students and the quality of the engineers that are involved, and on that metric we've got an exceptionally strong team, so we're hoping to show that.
It opens up a world of opportunities being a part of something like this. Not only do you get, you know, really close to a lot of professional people that then could potentially offer you employment through that way, it also looks really good on your resume to other employers.
I myself have applied for the BMW internship, which one of our team members has already been on. That's a 3-month internship in Germany. I've also been employed by one of our sponsors because of the work that I've done.
We're working with an amazing bunch of students. QUT brings some incredible students to this team, and we've had an opportunity to work with them and mentor them and have some amazing life experiences along the way.
A combination of a strong alumni, people who have done it before, and a new wave of young students who come through with their passion and their enthusiasm. We want to keep this going, yeah, indefinitely.
And we're hoping to build a high performance solar electric sports car that's road registrable.
The idea is hopefully it can be registered so you can drive a solar car to the shops and do your shopping and take your kids to school and do real life things with the real life solar car, and that's our goal.